Hey everybody, welcome back to Record-ology. Okay, I'm super excited for this episode. I say that every time because I'm always excited. This is gonna be cool though. So we're gonna be taking a look at one of my favorite things in the world, portable CD players. I love these things. They're so cool. I remember back in like 1993, 94, this was the thing to have. I remember going to school with like these big leather padded things. In fact, I got teased for carrying around a purse when it was a CD case. You know, you put your CD player in the top, little zipper compartment, padded kind of leather thing, and then you could put like three or four CDs underneath that. You have the strap, you feel so cool wearing that around, sitting there before class starts and just listening to your music a little bit. And it was so premium, it was so nice to have. After going through, you know, a couple decades of cassettes and kind of acclimating to that and what it meant to have music on cassette, rewinding, pausing, flipping the tape over, to be able to instantly skip tracks, to have premium digital sound, all that good stuff. It was super, super exciting. So I'm gonna be doing something interesting today. We're gonna be taking a look at an awesome new portable CD player from Studebaker that's probably the coolest looking CD player I've ever seen in my life. We're gonna pit that against my old trusted, tried and true CD player from 1994, my Sony D-131, the gold standard. And that's just personal to me because that was my first one. So we're gonna unbox the new one, take a look at it, review it, and then pit it side by side against my old Sony and see how it stacks up. You're not gonna wanna miss this.
This is Record-ology.
All right guys, and here it is. And it looks just like a 1956 Studebaker President automobile, guys, with a two-tone teal and white. What a gorgeous car, and what a gorgeous CD player. Looking on the back here, it does have FM radio, 60-second anti-skip. It'll play CDRs and RWs. How fun to see a brand new CD player and unpackage this. You know, this is not something that you do much these days, open a brand new CD player, but this looks gorgeous. The package is striking. It invokes a very 1950s vibe with the colors and the font. The whole thing is just gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. Look at the black and white checkered tiles there. It does come with headphones, and I'll tell you why in a minute. But let's go ahead and rip into this package. As you can see me doing right now, it is packaged well, but it's not impossible to get into, and you're not gonna cut your fingers opening it up. Oh, it just, it's gorgeous. I love it. It is so beautiful. And inside here, you've got the headphones, and here's the user manual. You'll probably wanna hang on to this in case you've forgotten over the years. It'll tell you how to play a CD and a CD player, but actually it's gonna show you some of the other functions as well, like how to operate the radio and all of that good stuff. So I always recommend keeping these on file. You never know when you're gonna need some information out of there. And here it is, little clip to open the lid right there. There's a paper insert that'll protect the laser lens. And here it is in all of its glory, guys. If you were to try and take a 1950s theme and turn it into a CD player, you could do no better than this. We're taking a tour right around the edge here, you guys. Sort of a silver accent on the buttons. All of the jacks and connections are made towards the outside edge with all of the transport controls and play functions on top. It is powered off of two AA batteries, just like this. And here it is, the Sony D-131, the gold standard in my opinion. And let's take a look around the outside of this. Just a fantastic piece of industrial design, you guys. But now it's time for a side-by-side comparison. Here we go. This new CD player, although gorgeous, has a lot to live up to. And we're gonna just compare side by side some of the basic functions and features. Let's start with the lid. The Sony lid pops up when you push the button there a little bit, and then you have to raise it into position. Whereas the Studebaker is on a powerful hinge, and when you open the latch on the front there, it actually swings all the way up, which is kind of nice. I actually prefer the Studebaker in this regard, because if you're trying to play the CD and you've only got one hand free, this is actually much better. This is something you might have never noticed before. See these indents here? These are to help you pick up the disc off of the spindle, and it gives you a little finger hole in order to grab it. There's two of them at a 3-inch disc position and the 5-inch disc position. All right, the Sony is powered off of the 4.5 power jack on the back, or AA batteries. My old Sony here, the little battery compartment cover does come off. I don't remember if it used to do that or not, but now you can clip it into place, but unfortunately it does come off. All right, let's take a look at the Studebaker's power, and as you can see, it has the same 4.5 power supply, but you can use a micro USB to power the device. It doesn't charge batteries, but it will power the device, and you could power it off of AA batteries with a nice sturdy battery compartment cover. In this regard, the Studebaker wins hands down. Lots of power options and a great battery door, and little rubberized feet on the bottom, more of them than the Sony has. So it has a nice stable position on smooth surfaces like this granite countertop. As far as CD player controls, the Sony's are right up front here, which can be a little inconvenient depending on what angle you're looking at it. There's also little switches there for the AVLS, which is the automatic volume limiter switch, as well as the bass boost, and the hold switch is over here on the left. I'm pretty much used to operating like this, but you do have to pick it up and kind of tilt it into your field of view. Whereas the Studebaker is really nice. If you're hand holding it, you can access all those controls right on the top there, which from an ergonomic standpoint is actually a little bit easier. It's actually significantly easier. You've got all of your transport controls and that gorgeous Studebaker badge on the front. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the displays. On the Sony here, it's gonna show the track number, and then it's also gonna show a counter for the tracks. It starts off by showing you the total running time of the disc, and then it allows you to count through the disc as you progress through the tracks. And I love how they prominently feature the compact disc logo on there. Let's take a look at the display on the Studebaker. It is right on top there, which I think is really cool. By the way, don't forget to turn the hold switch off. It's on the bottom. That's kind of a funky place for it. I wish it was somewhere else. It starts off by reading the disc, and it will give you a very similar display: total running time of the disc, track count of the disc, and then track number, as well as a time counter throughout the track. It's just kind of flipped from the order in which the Sony does it, but the same basic principles apply. It'll also show when the ESP or electronic skip protection is on. This does have a 60 second anti-skip, so you can shake it, you can supposedly jog with it. It's got a 60 second buffer. By the way that works is it just buffers the music into a RAM and it's played off of the RAM, similar to the way a mini disc works. These are both fully programmable, although the Studebaker is the only one that features the FM radio. And the reason why they include headphones is you have to have a pair of headphones connected for the antenna, but you'll want to upgrade those headphones right away. The Sony features a line level output, an awesome knob volume control, and the headphone jack. Conversely, the Studebaker has these tiny cheap plastic buttons for volume control that's actually really hard to control. I definitely prefer the Sony in this regard. Plus, the Studebaker does not have the line level output. All right, here it is. This is a Sinatra CD. We're going to be playing some music from the 50s, of course, and we're going to be recording that directly into my handy dandy Zoom H2N handy recorder, and we're going to be recording it at a CD quality or above resolution. Now I'm going to go in here and turn off the limiter and the automatic gain control. So we're going to hear this as though your headphones were plugged directly into the unit. So this is your headphone warning, guys. If you're not listening on headphones, put them in right now, because you're going to hear a direct feed and we're going to compare these side by side to see how they sound. Let's start off with the Sony and here we go.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can. It's 2:45. There's no one in the place. When I was 17.
They sound amazingly similar. The Sony is my gold standard, so I'm going to give that a 10 out of 10. It's got a little bit of hiss, but it's a warm, welcoming hiss. I love it. Now, the Studebaker was very close. I'd give it a 9 out of 10. It was a little bit harsher. The bass wasn't quite as good as the Discman, but it was very, very close.
Okay, guys, and that's it. Isn't that awesome? What a cool player. I love it. And you can't beat the look of it, guys. It just looks fantastic. If you want to get your hands on this awesome little CD player, click the link in the description below. We've got some amazing things coming up in the very near future, guys. Hit subscribe if you haven't done so already. Tell a friend about the show that doesn't know about it. But for now, happy record hunting. We'll see you next time.